In New Zealand's North Island, we have large geothermal areas, and the expression of these geothermal areas is as volcanoes, large heated lakes, even geysers, where water is ejected out of the ground into the air, hot springs and steaming soils. So in the 1000 Springs project, we're trying to do something that has never been done before. We are sampling 1000 springs across the Taupo volcanic zone, as many different physical and chemical conditions as we can get. No matter what acidity or what alkalinity, and no matter what temperature, there will be life in all of these hot springs. Certainly there are billions of microorganisms per litre of water in these springs. In the 1000 Springs project, one of the aims is to do a stock take of the microorganisms that inhabit the geothermal systems in New Zealand. At the present moment, we have absolutely no idea what species exist in these pools, or even the numbers of the species. We have no idea whether the microorganisms in one pool are globally unique, never found anywhere else in the world, or they're found everywhere. We don't really understand how microorganisms move from one place to the next. A hot spring is like a continent for a microorganism. Moving one hot spring to the next hot spring is actually a really difficult logistical challenge. Microorganisms are able to deal with these really unusual conditions, and if they can do that, then we may be able to harness some of their abilities for biotechnologies. Today we're at Whakarerua village in Rotorua. It has got hundreds of different hot springs. They're all varieties of shapes and colours, temperatures, acidities. So when we arrive at the hot spring, we first of all make sure it's safe to sample. We then take the temperature, record that, and then we take four different water samples. Some of them are to determine what chemicals are within the spring water. Some determine what gases are in the spring water. And then we also take a water sample to filter the microorganisms for later extraction in the lab. We determine what microorganisms are in the hot spring samples by extracting their DNA and comparing it to a global database. It takes 15 minutes roughly to sample each spring. So in a day we're aiming to sample about 10 to 12 hot springs, and then we take them back to the lab. So we're going to process the samples we collected today at Whakarerua. Jean and Dave are about to filter the samples. This is the microbiology lab that we do it in. It's a nice clean environment.
So here's two of our samples that we took earlier today. We've got 582 and 583, and each of them is hooked up to this peristaltic pump.
So this column filter, basically the pump pushes the sample through it, and the filter is so small, it's 0.2 of a micron.
So most microbes will actually be captured onto this filter. The next part of the whole process is we do a DNA extraction on that filter. So basically what the DNA extraction does, it just cracks open the cells, and we're able to get access to the DNA of the microorganisms in there.
The DNA from these microorganisms trapped on the filter, we then isolate the DNA to use it to identify the microorganisms in the sample. And this is a image of what we get from that readout. So if we go over here, we take that DNA those DNA sequences we just saw, and we can represent them in a different way. What we have here is a pie chart that shows the microbial species that inhabit this hot spring. So if you imagine this pie chart as wedges of a pie, the larger the wedge, the more of that particular microorganism is present in that hot spring. So you can see this pie wedge here represents the majority of bacteria in this hot spring, and these little wedges here are minor components of the hot spring.
So at the end of all this sampling, we have tried to measure as many of the physical conditions of the spring. And we also have information on the microbes living in there. So basically we know what's living in there, we know the physical conditions of the spring, so we're looking at the links between the two. From all this information, we're basically getting a deeper understanding of what's going on in these hot springs, where the microorganisms are getting all their nutrients from, how they're surviving, and how they all differ from each other.
This project is in the early phases of discovery. We've never undertaken such a project before in the history of microbial ecology in New Zealand. We don't know what we're going to find. It's all very exciting. There's lots of things to understand about this crucial part of global ecosystems. I'm sure that we're going to be finding new discoveries and generating new knowledge about these fascinating and crucial life forms that we know so little about, but are absolutely everywhere in our world.